Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Right now we're at the National Conference for Special Session of the Parliament on Agrarian Crisis, organised by the Nation of Farmers. This is to discuss the agrarian crisis, especially in light of the most recent farmers' protest from Nashik to Mumbai that shook the entire country. Today is the start of a three-day session that will discuss the onslaught and attack faced by youth, workers, farmers and women today. Let's take a look at some of the key issues that were discussed here ahead of the special session.
Welcome to the Nation for Farmers Conference and Convention.
Before the neoliberal reform started, before trade openness started, why did you not hear of debt-induced farmer suicides? It was because our agriculture was protected. It was protected from free inflow and outflow of global commodities.
Ideally, I agree, and we should all put our demand that, you know, we should come out of this neoliberal framework, reverse the economic reforms, bring back all the protective mechanisms, including policies, laws, and institutional arrangements, revive them, and also, you know, enhance, you know, support mechanism. This is the point I wish to make. But I think, second point is that, Even if we are not able to do this immediately, at least we can revive the institutions and protective mechanisms that we used to operate earlier.
शहरों में जब जमीन आती है तब आप सिर्फ नीचे का टुकड़ा नहीं नापते, आप तो ऊपर भी नापते और उसे कहते हो फ्लोर स्पेस इंडेक्स. तो कभी तो फार्मर्स की सिक्योरिटी की बात कीजिए और कहिए कि फार्मर्स सिक्योरिटी इंडेक्स क्या होगा.
After 20-30 years of atomization and self-centered hedonism, the middle classes have come out in a big way to participate in the marches of farmers and farm laborers. And that has happened from Punjab to Tamil Nadu. And that is such a significant development.
So the most important thing that was brought about by this whole farmers effort, and I think to the Nation for Farmers effort, the idea to add to that, ki the kisan movement will set the agenda, lekin kisano ke movement ko sahi desh ki rajniti ka hissa banana hai, to aur bhi logon ko judna padega ye samajhte hue ki ye kisano ka desh hai, mazdooron ka desh hai, aur is desh mein yadi hum samanta aur nyay lana chahte hain, we must connect with these movements so that all these issues concern everyone the way they should.
Ek karyakarta ne nikali thi sari jankari ki kitne stall ho gaye projects land acquisition ki wajah se. 801 project ki list mili thi jisme se sirf 8% जमीन के लिए रुके थे, जमीन अवेलेबल नहीं हुई, इसलिए उसमें से 45% ये थे जिसके लिए इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं हो रही थी. तो तब हमने नारा ये दिया था कि आप जमीन नहीं मिलती है तो लैंड एक्विजिशन कानून लाते हो, पूंजी या कैपिटल नहीं आएगा तो कैपिटल एक्विजिशन एक्ट लाने की बात करोगे क्या?
वी रियली रिक्वायर अ स्पेशल सेशन ऑफ पार्लियामेंट फॉर मिनिमम 3 weeks वेयर ऑल दीज इशूज विल बी डिस्कस्ड, solutions will be found, and one of the important things that must be discussed in such a special session of parliament is the National Commission on Farmers report. The National Commission, which was headed by Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, the report was submitted in all 5 parts by 2006. Today it is 2019. Last 13 years parliament has not spent even 1 minute discussing this very, very crucial report of the Swaminathan Commission, which is not limited only to the recommendation of remunerative prices of 1.5 times the cost of production, but it has a number of other recommendations which are very valuable, which require to be discussed threadbare and in detail. Apart from this, there are 4 or 5 very, very major issues which require to be really dealt with absolutely frontally today if the agrarian crisis is to be resolved. Actually, we are not demanding it as something like arms over there at all. We are demanding this as a right, because these farmers have been looted by the government and by the market over the last several years. In fact, several decades ever since independence. We are very much aware that just a loan waiver will not solve the problems of agriculture, nor will it solve the problems of farmers on a long-term basis. Simply because if the current policies continue, the same kind of loan and indebtedness is going to afflict farmers very soon again. Not only this, the Swaminathan Commission itself said, simply declaring MSP at 1.5 times the cost of production is not enough. The government must set up a machinery at every mandi level to be able to buy the agricultural produce of the peasantry at that price. Today, more than half the country is reeling under drought. Kerala was reeling under very bad floods, the worst in a century. Assam, Bihar, etc., we are having floods or drought. So therefore, in case of natural calamities, there has to be a really pro-farmer comprehensive crop insurance scheme which is in place, not the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, which is a farce, which is meant not to help farmers but to help insurance companies make tremendous profits. This kind of a crop insurance scheme is not at all what we have in mind. We must have a comprehensive crop insurance scheme which will actually help farmers in distress as a result of natural calamities. The fourth important thing that we have to struggle all over the country is regarding agricultural workers. That is a huge section today, landless, having to just work on agriculture for just sustaining themselves. And as a result, we have a situation where in 2005-06, the MNREGA, National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, was actually promulgated, passed by Parliament. And we have seen in the last 5 years, every attempt has been made to undermine this very important lifeline for the agricultural workers of India. And as a result of this, we are seeing that the agricultural workers, what they had promised in the Act, 100 days per work, they are not even getting 20 days per work on an average, as a result of the fact that the government is not giving the outlay required for making this MNREGA scheme a success. The fifth important point concerns issues of land rights and land acquisition. We have just seen the Supreme Court judgment on the 20th of February, where they asked for eviction of tribals who are not made eligible under the Forest Rights Act. It was a completely unfortunate and insensitive judgment, putting the onus on the Adivasi farmers, whereas the onus should be on the central and state government for not having implemented the Forest Rights Act in the spirit in which they should have done that. It's a welcome thing that the Supreme Court has today reviewed its own judgment and has taken back the eviction clause today, which is a good thing. But at the same time, the Forest Rights Act needs to be implemented in a large way all over the country. The sixth and the last thing which I would like to say regarding social services and the entire question of social welfare. This is a very important aspect of the agrarian crisis today, and this is being totally watered down by successive governments as a result of the neoliberal policies. So issues like education, issues like employment, issues such as health, issues of the Dalits, of the Adivasis, of very important section, farmer women, these are all issues which come under the category of social welfare, under the category of social justice. And I think that these all issues also are extremely vital, and they need to be really resolved on a war footing if some kind of a equality is to be achieved.